candidates on stage Wednesday night said Mike Pence did the right thing on January 6th. Do you agree?
I would have done it very differently. I think that there was a historic opportunity that he missed to reunite this country in that window. What I would have said is this is a moment for a true national consensus where there's two elements of what's required for a functioning democracy in America. One is secure elections, and the second is a peaceful transfer of power. When those things come into conflict, that's an opportunity for heroism.
GOP presidential candidate Vivek Ramaswamy believes that former Vice President Mike Pence squandered an opportunity for heroism on January 6th by basically coming back and ensuring that he certified the election after the January 6th Capitol riots. Now, with that said, why don't we take a look at what Ramaswamy claims he would do differently and try not to lose your mind over how ridiculous this is. Let's watch.
Here's what I would have said. We need single day voting on election day. We need paper ballots and we need government issued ID matching the voter file. And if we achieve that, then we have achieved victory and we should not have any further complaint about election integrity.
So what would, so what would you have done
through the Senate?
So what would you have done with Mike Pence? You would have not certified the election?
So in my capacity as president of the Senate, I would have led through that level of reform. Then on that condition, certified the election results, served it up to the president. Yeah. President Trump then to sign that into law. And on January 7th, declared the re-election campaign pursuant to a free and fair election. I think that was a missed opportunity, but that's the kind of spirit we're gonna need to unite this country rather than sweeping those concerns under the rug.
That was one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard. A presidential candidate say, and that's saying something because lots of presidential candidates have said all sorts of insane things on the campaign trail. I don't understand. I thought Republicans didn't believe in federalizing our elections, right? I thought they believed that each state should have its own rules in regard to how they conduct elections. But on top of that, the idea, like the naivete here, that Donald Trump would say, okay, you know what? Here are the reforms, I'm gonna sign them through executive order and then I'm good. Then I'm gonna back off and accept that I lost the election.
Not only that, look, he's purposely being a jackass. None of that makes any sense. First, let me just knock down his specific proposals. So two out of three were same day voting and you need government issued ID. Well, that would eliminate all mail-in voting for no reason at all. The Democrats are never going to agree to that. By the way, earlier before lunatic Trump, the Republicans would have never agreed to that.
Yeah.
Because a lot of their voters are senior citizens who need to mail in their votes, right?
Okay, but what's amazing is that he's not even having a conversation about Democrats or Congress. He thinks that this could just happen with Donald Trump executing an executive order, just signing, you know, his signature on a piece of paper.
Yeah, I mean, this guy, you're an outsider. You have an extra responsibility to know what the hell you're talking about. Mm-hmm. And you're unfortunately hurting other outsiders by being a clown. And so, like, you can't get the Democrats to agree to any of this. So you obviously couldn't have passed it as a bill. The Democrats controlled the House and the Senate at the time. You can't do it through executive order and you can't nationalize these elections. So none of that makes any sense. But you were gonna do all of that and that was gonna be your compromise by January 6th.
No. He was gonna get those concessions, I guess on some sort of document that Donald Trump would sign on January 6th. And then after he signs it, then they certify the election on January 7th. Also, what's left out of this conversation is the powers that the vice president has and does not have. He did not have the ability to avoid certifying the election.
Yeah, so those jackass ideas were just appetizers for the main meal. The main meal is, I would have held up the certification until I got these demands. You don't have that authority. It's a ceremonial role. Get it through your thick head, okay? And he knows that because he wrote it in his book. He's a giant liar. He already knows that the vice president doesn't have that authority. The vice president goes, it's like the guy who opens the envelope at the Oscars. The voting already happened, you moron. You can't be like, Avatar won, but I didn't like that movie. So I'm going to demand same day voting and then maybe I'll let Avatar win. That's not how it works, okay? So just, he's getting more attention. The more clownish he is, the more attention he gets. So he goes home and chuckles anyway.
Now, earlier this month, by the way, Vivek Ramaswamy reportedly sidestepped questions asked by Politico about whether he would have certified the election results. He told Politico, quote, "I would have never let it get to that point. I would have never put myself or been part of an administration if I was in a serious position of leadership to ever have allowed us to have gotten to that doorstep."
Oh, please tell me what you would have done with Donald Trump.
Please, actually, please. Don't, but just don't. Don't embarrass yourself like you did earlier.
No. I would love that. Tell me how you would have forced Donald Trump to accept those results. I would not have been part of this. So would you have quit? And would you have resigned saying, oh, it turns out the president is a giant cheater. We know he didn't win, but he's pretending that he won. By the way, Vivek wrote that already in his book, so he knows it's true.
Yes.
So you want to say it again, bitch? Say it again. Say it on TV. Oh no, you're trying to kiss up to Trump voters and MAGA guys, and you haven't found a place on Donald Trump's body to appease yet. So all of a sudden, oh, the great, wonderful Donald Trump. Loser, total careerist, opportunist, slimy loser, Vivek Ramaswamy.
Now, Chuck Todd, who I've definitely had issues with, did a pretty good job in referencing Ramaswamy's book and what he said about Donald Trump and the 2020 presidential election in the book versus what Ramaswamy is now saying publicly on the campaign trail. And so there were multiple examples of this, but I want to show you my favorite example. Let's take a look.
You're referring to Republicans. We use stolen election theories as a backdoor to embracing our own victim identity path, pursuing an easy path to power. Throughout this entire book, you mock the entire January 6th aspect. You absolutely criticize Donald Trump for being a sore loser. You write about it in a way of making your point that we've become a nation of victims. And right now on TV, you're doing the exact opposite.
I'm not. Chuck, actually, want to be very clear. I preached to conservative audiences I was in Iowa over the last 2 days. And what do I tell them? We're not going to be victims. We're going to be victorious. Whether I'm talking to the left or the right, I say the same thing. I've also been very clear, Chuck, and I want to be clear today, that I would have made very different judgments than Donald Trump did that day and on many of the matters in his path out of office. But there's a difference between a bad judgment and a crime. And what I've been clear about is when we criminalize those bad judgments, that's an abuse of the justice system. It undermines trust, not only in our elections, but in our justice system.
By the way, he also earlier in that interview argued that it was not a free and fair election because of the censorship of the New York Post Hunter Biden story. I don't really think that made that much of a difference. I think voters were more concerned about Trump's handling of the coronavirus pandemic and how much he essentially bungled the response to it. But I do agree that it was wrong for that New York Post piece on Hunter Biden's laptop getting censored in social media platforms. They should not have done that despite the lies that were told about where it actually came from. Nonetheless, Cenk, was that convincing? His defense of what he wrote in his book?
So first of all, by the way, the Hunter Biden thing, that was totally unclear about any effect that it had. But the Anthony Weiner laptop thing that James Comey came up with the last second of the election in 2016, there was excellent evidence that that cost Hillary Clinton the election. And so is anybody on the right wing complaining about that election interference?
Of course not.
Of course not. Okay, so we'll call that even and move on. Look, last thing here, Vivek. So is Donald Trump a sore loser? Answer the question. Super easy question. You alluded to it in your book. Now you're flopping around like a fish out there. Mm-hmm. Flip-flopping. I love MAGA. But let me be really clear. No, you haven't been clear at all, brother. You haven't been clear at all. Is Donald Trump a sore loser? Answer the goddamn question. He will never answer that. All he'll give you is slime coming out of his mouth in both directions. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.